Hey friends, it's another episode of Azure Friday, and this time it's more devices, Windows 10 IoT. We've got device management with Windows 10 IoT and Azure IoT, and you brought a big screen, which makes me happy. So what's behind this big screen?
So this is actually a Raspberry Pi, just similar to the other ones that we've used in other demos, like Olivier's recent demo.
Okay.
And this particular Raspberry Pi is running Windows 10 IoT Core, which is Microsoft's Windows version that's targeted specifically at IoT devices. Mm-hmm. And in IoT Core, it's targeted at resource-constrained devices. Mm. So small devices, small memory, small storage, that sort of thing. Mm-hmm.
Now, anyone who's watching who has a Raspberry Pi, and I know a lot of people do, should remember or be reminded by us, they can pull their SD card out and they can make one with Windows IoT.
Yes, absolutely.
You may have Raspbian. Try out Windows IoT, connect to it with Visual Studio, and do some of the things that we're going to do today.
Exactly. So the IoT Core is actually shipped to two different groups. Mm-hmm. We ship it to hobbyists and prototypers, mm-hmm. and we ship those as actual images designed for a specific device. So as you said, you can get the image, just plug it in, and off you go. We also ship to OEMs, and for OEMs, they have the ability to customize the image to their platform, insert the drivers that are specific for their platform, that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. And also for the hobbyists and the prototypers, we have a free version of Visual Studio available.
Nice.
And so you can download the image, download Visual Studio, and you're immediately ready to go and start developing.
This is great, and I can see you've also got a Spark Fun connected to your GPIO. So even though you're running Windows 10 and you're on a Raspberry Pi, you're talking GPIO to a Spark Fun off-the-shelf temperature sensor.
That's right, and you can talk to sensors through WinRT on an IoT device. And so we've extended the WinRT model for IoT specifically, because on an IoT device, generally speaking, you're talking to a lot of sensors, you're gathering data, and you're doing the normal IoT loop of gathering the data, doing some analysis on it, sending it to the cloud, doing more in-depth analysis, making some decisions, sometimes changing the functionality of the device to optimize it, but certainly using that data to optimize your business long term.
And because you're using WinRT, you're using a familiar app model, you're writing C#, you're using Visual Studio. People who are listening, who might be doing text boxes over data at your company in the daytime, you could be writing embedded code and smaller
That's
systems
right.
with the C# that you already know how to use.
Exactly. And Windows 10 IoT Core supports the UWP model, which supports universal drivers, universal apps. Mm-hmm. And so those applications can be written in such a way that they'll run on an IoT device or on Windows. And so you can do some of your development directly on Windows and then bring the app down to IoT Core.
Cool. Now, I'm noticing, though, when I've done my IoT work in the past, I've usually had a USB cable. I've usually had the thing very much tethered to my machine. But this appears to be a managed device. It's on the internet, but it's not connected to your computer.
That's correct. And in fact, one of the things I want to talk about is the fact that in Windows IoT, and especially in Windows IoT Core, we've been doing a lot of work to integrate Azure more deeply into the product, and we'll continue to do that. Of course, Microsoft's IoT story includes both Azure IoT and Windows IoT. And although Azure IoT is specifically designed to be platform agnostic and works everywhere, as part of the Windows team, we want to make sure that it works best with Windows. And so we've been doing some things to create applications, make it easier to get started, make it easier to get connected, make it easier to actually use. And so, for example, on Olivier's previous talk, he talked about device twin and how you could use device twin for device management. And so what we've done is we've actually taken the device twin concept and actual device twin in the cloud, and we've written a device management application that uses device twin but maps the device management capabilities to the actual CSPs within Windows, which are that's basically the code that all of our device management clients use to manipulate Windows. Mm-hmm. And so when your IT department pushes down new Wi-Fi settings, for example, whether it comes through SCCM or Intune, you can do the same thing with Azure IoT using this.
And what's really interesting about this is that he wouldn't use device twin to do something trivial where he blinked an LED, but now you're going to do something really sophisticated with Windows IoT.
That's correct. So there's a couple of things here. So first of all, this is the application portal. Anybody who gets our image or has played with our image This is actually running on the device, and so this is a way that you can interact with the device and see what's happening on the device, view processes, and
so
that sort of thing.
Just to be clear, this here, that IP address, you're hitting that right now.
That's correct.
It served this. This is the remote UI.
That's correct.
For lack of another word. And you could also PowerShell in if you wanted
to. Yeah, of course, yes. And in this case in particular, I want to show that we're running the IoT device management background task, which
okay.
is what's ultimately talking to the cloud.
Mm-hmm.
And then if I go down here and I look at the processes that are running.
Right, so there's your task manager.
This is task manager, exactly.
Yeah. And I can see you're actually running an app here. This is a real app. It's got the weather, and this is an UWP app.
Yes, yep.
Okay.
Real map, real weather. You can see the good old Seattle weather.
No fake demos on
no
Azure
fake
Friday.
Demo. And so system configurator is actually the NT service that's running in the background that is doing that conversion for us to actually talk to the CSPs and the underlying platform.
All right.
And so, one of the important things about getting these devices out in the field is that you really have to be aware of security. You have to have a security response plan.
Mm-hmm.
You see this all the time. Lots of stats on people who have used code or whatever, don't keep it up to date, and then the next thing you know, you've got a vulnerability that you didn't have to have. Well, one of the great things about Windows IoT, of course, is that it's Windows. We have a very strong security response plan for Windows.
Mm-hmm.
And Windows IoT is based on the same code, the same security. And because we have Windows Update and other update mechanisms, we can actually keep the platform itself secure over time.
Mm.
And so that's, if an OEM opts to do that, that's a way for us to essentially help them keep their products secure in the field.
Yeah, that's a deeply important thing, and don't people realize. I know that I have, personally in my house, I don't know if they're plugged in right now, IoT light bulbs.
Yeah.
Have been long abandoned, running old, unpatched Linux things that I probably should just unplug.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So what this is the device management portal,
okay.
and I'll talk about that in a second. But if I come over here for a second here, this is actually the device twin information coming from the device itself.
Right, so this is the JavaScript shadow, the proxy
exactly.
to the device. This is the cloud's representation of the device's properties?
Exactly. And in fact, they're editable. And so you could come in here and actually put in the JSON to manipulate
cool.
the device.
And that's what Olivier did in his previous one. He put in a desired property that he wished an LED to blink.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
That makes sense.
Now, of course, typing in the JSON is not particularly friendly.
No. Nope.
And so what we did was we, created this portal.
Mm-hmm.
It's not intended to be a production portal.
Of course.
Really intended to be, to make this easy to play with and manipulate.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a sample, so someone who really wants to make a portal can actually do it.
Cool.
Now, of course, the clients on the device are real.
Right.
And so what we've done here is, we've created this portal that has some sections for various things. If you want to reboot the device
sure.
or take a snapshot of what's running or that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
What I've populated in here is an application and the necessary dependencies on an application.
Right.
And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually use Device Twin to put the application up through the cloud and down to the device.
Okay, so if I understand correctly, you're going to say that these are the desired characteristics of this device. I'm going to apply those to the Device Twin, and then Azure IoT is going to impose those upon this. And because it has an agent running locally that respects that, they're going to work together to make sure that happens in a secure and effective way.
Absolutely.
All right.
Now, one thing I should say is that in this particular case, we've actually put the application in Azure Storage.
Oh.
And so as part of the Device Twin, rather than actually putting it in the Device Twin going out to multiple devices.
You're pushing a pointer and you're saying it's over
exactly.
there.
Exactly. We push a pointer and say it's over there.
Totally valid. All right. So then you set the app's configuration. That, again, is setting it to the twin. And then it
That's
is
correct.
In a kind of a synchronization dance, it is being imposed upon the device. The device now is running, already it's happening. So a new UWP app is coming in.
Correct.
Yeah, that's a toaster.
Yes.
You've turned a Raspberry Pi into a toaster. That's amazing.
So not as sexy as the first app. But it was an easy app. It's a sample, and it shows the purpose of the device.
That's pretty cool.
And so the combination of mapping the device twin
mm-hmm.
Off to the on device CSPs,
yep.
gives you immediately a lot of understandable, very common Windows device management tasks available. Mm-hmm. Aside from the device management client, which we've made available on Git, mm-hmm. And we'll provide some links to that. Well, we've also created a client for the recently public previewed Azure device provisioning service. Mm-hmm. And so now you can actually use that client on the device, mm-hmm. and when you turn your device on in the field for the first time, the device will go to Azure, uh-huh. it'll get all the information it needs, it'll actually move over to the correct IoT hub, and get all the provisioning information it needs.
That makes me think about the first time I ever saw what was called a Pixie boot, where a PXE boot, where you go to a really managed network and you take your laptop right out of the box and you boot off the network and it goes, oh, I work at Microsoft, and it sets itself up and it saves you lots of time. So you're saying devices that come off the shelf that are part of my fleet,
yes,
would provision themselves and become immediately useful.
Correct. That's very much like that, except through the cloud.
Through the cloud.
So you can disperse them, throughout the world and manage them.
That's cool. So where do we go to learn about all of this stuff? It's Azure.com, and look at the IoT Hub section?
Azure.com, IoT Hub. You can also go to the Microsoft IoT site.
Okay.
We've actually started combining the resources of both Azure IoT and Windows IoT up there.
All right.
And we'll provide some links for that. And of course, the clients are on Git, and we have quite a few samples and other useful pieces of code there. Mm-hmm. And so we'll provide some links for that as well.
Fantastic. And I can't say it enough, if you've got a Raspberry Pi at your house, and I know you do, pop out that that Raspbian image and check out Windows 10 IoT. You can run it on your Raspberry Pi today, and you can swap them back and forth. Very
Absolutely.
Cool. Thanks so much for your time.
Yeah.
I am learning all about Azure IoT and Windows 10 IoT Core here on Azure Friday.